Good morning, students. Today we are going to see about biology. The first lesson in biology is plant anatomy and plant physiology. Plant anatomy is a study of internal structure of plants, and plant physiology is the study of physical forms of plants and its function. Nehemiah grew. He is an English plant anatomist. He is known as father of plant anatomy. A group of cells join together and it form tissues. A group of tissues perform similar functions. All the organisms are made up of tissues. Sack classifies the plant tissue system into three main types. One is dermal or epidermal tissue system. Second one is ground tissue system, and third one is vascular tissue system. The dermal tissue system, it is the outermost layer. It consists of two components, one is epidermis, another one is periderm. Ground tissue system consists of three main components, one is parenchyma, second one is colenchyma, and third one is clearenchyma. These are the three kinds of cells which are present in the ground tissue. The function of the parenchyma is food storage. These cells are used to store the food. And the function of colenchyma, clearenchyma is mechanical support. These cells giving the mechanical support to the inner cells or inner tissues. And the third one is vascular tissue system. This tissue system, it is present in the inner portion of the plant. It consists of two components, one is xylem, another one is phloem. Already you know about xylem and phloem. Xylem conducts water and minerals, and phloem conducts food materials to the different parts of the plant. So these are the three different tissue system. The dermal is present in the outside of this plant part, and ground tissue system is present in the middle. Vascular, it is the inner part. Now we are going to study about detailly vascular tissue system. This vascular tissue system sometimes arranged in the form of bundles. For this reason, it is said to be as vascular bundles. Vascular bundles are of three types. One is radial, conjoint, and concentric. In radial type vascular bundle, xylem and phloem arranged in different radii. Look at this diagram. This is xylem and this is phloem. Xylem is arranged in one radii and phloem is arranged in another radii. Likewise, xylem and phloem arranged alternatively. This type of arrangement is known as radial vascular bundle. Second one is conjoint vascular bundle. Here the xylem and phloem arranged in same radii. Look at this diagram. This is xylem and this is phloem. Both are arranged in same radii. This type of arrangement is called as conjoint vascular bundle. Third one is concentric vascular bundle. Here one is surrounded by the another. For example, sometimes the phloem surrounds the xylem, or the xylem surrounds the phloem. This type of arrangement is known as concentric vascular bundle. The conjoint vascular bundle is of two types. One is collateral, another one is bicollateral. In collateral, xylem lies towards the center and phloem lies towards the outside. This type of arrangement is known as collateral. In bicollateral, xylem is present in the inner side and outer side phloem is present. This type of arrangement is known as bicollateral. Bi in the sense two. So it is covered by phloem. Both the side it is covered by phloem. So this type of arrangement is known as bicollateral. Again, the conjoint vascular bundle is classified into two types. One is open, another one is closed based on the presence of cambium tissue. If the cambium tissue is present between the xylem and the phloem, it is said to be as open. If the cambium is absent between the xylem and the phloem, it is said to be as closed. And next one is concentric vascular bundle. In concentric vascular bundle is classified into two types. One is amphivasal, another one is amphicribral. In amphivasal, xylem surrounds the phloem. In amphicribral, phloem surrounds the xylem. This type of arrangement is known as amphicribral. So, apart from that, one more classification is there, that is endarch mode of arrangement or exarch mode of arrangement based on the xylem. So, in endarch, the protoxylem lies towards the center and metaxylem lies towards the periphery. Protoxylem, it is the smallest xylem. The smallest xylem lies towards the center and the metaxylem is the biggest xylem that lies towards the periphery. That type of arrangement is known as endarch. In exarch condition, protoxylem lies towards the periphery and metaxylem, that is the biggest xylem, lies towards the center. So proto means smallest xylem and meta means biggest xylem. Look at this diagram. These are xylem. So this is the biggest one. The biggest xylem lies towards the center and the smallest one lies towards the periphery. So metaxylem lies towards the center in the sense it is exarch mode of arrangement. That's all about today's class. Kindly make a notes and thereby you can easily understand the topic.